TVNZ's RE has released a new series on religious sects and cults. As part of it, they spoke to Vaughan Thomas, who was raised in the exclusive Brethren Church and asked to leave when he was 22 years old. We're lucky enough to have Vaughan with us this morning. Kia ora, Vaughan. Thanks for being here. Good morning. People who don't know about the exclusive Brethren, can you just tell us a bit about the Brethren?
The Brethren are a religious sect, often referred to as a cult. They're over the world, around the world, about 48,000 members and 8,000 here in New Zealand that practice Christian principles in a very basic sense in a closed group environment.
So what did that mean for you growing up inside the exclusive Brethren?
Growing up for me, that meant that I didn't have any contact with people outside of the church. I went to school in the church, I socialised with members of the church, and I worked for them, and my family, and the only family I had contact with was inside the church.
I suppose it's all you knew.
It was all you knew, because that's all you'd ever known. So there was no, very little comparison. You could always look on to the outside world, but that was a window to the outside world. That was all you could really see.
And what are some of the things that we in the outside world might take for granted that perhaps you didn't have access to inside the church?
They're very simple things, really. Technology as such, I didn't grow up with. Mobile phones, whilst they now have a version of them, we didn't grow up with that. We didn't grow up with television. We didn't grow up with even pre-recorded music, as we used to call it. Having a CD or a tape just wasn't the done thing. And going to the cinemas, it wasn't what we did.
So would you know who like Michael Jackson was, for example?
I knew of the name only purely because I remember going to the supermarket with my mum as a child and hearing the name over the radio. That was the only exposure that I had to that type of popular culture.
Wow. And you didn't have access to the internet? You couldn't use a computer?
No, absolutely not. I've only really been on the internet for about 6.5 years.
Wow. That's amazing, Vaughan. Can you tell us a little bit why you ended up leaving the Brethren?
I ended up leaving primarily because I disagreed with the way that things were run in the church, the way the leadership worked, and the principles of which they, what they refer to as head fellowship.
What does that mean?
That's the terms, I suppose, of which somebody inside the group I would identify, the practice of their faith, how they practice their faith, how they, I was trying to think of a better word, how they portray their faith.
Right, right. Was there disagreement between you and other church members about that?
There were, yes. It starts off very small, and then it becomes more and more noticeable. People tried to convince me to stay. They realised where it was going. They realised I was looking to leave, and they said to me, you know, oh, Vaughan, this is the place to be, and, you know, you're not going to make it if you leave, and you won't have success in life if you leave. So there was that pressure to remain.
What are the consequences of leaving?
The consequences are quite significant. When I did leave, I went through a 6-month period of effectively clinical culture shock. Everything was so different for me than what I thought it would be that I took that whole period of time to adjust just to simple things, using a TV remote, going to a restaurant. I'd never done that before. I didn't know how things worked or what I should or shouldn't do. It was completely foreign to me.
Yeah. Are you allowed to have contact with your family?
I don't think it's a case of am I allowed to. I think it's more will they talk to me. They're under a lot of pressure not to talk to me from the church, and also the, I suppose you could say, the indoctrination that the Brethren have to not talk to people who have left. In some ways they're effectively not there, or they've effectively died, yeah. But you know they're there, but there's just no recognition. I have no regular contact with my family at all. And most certainly I haven't since the day I left with a number of my friends growing up from birth.
I'm really sorry. That sucks.
Well, it is what it is, really. You learn to readjust and put your roots down again in fresh soil, really.
Do you have support?
Yes, I have support. I have an amazing partner, my friends and my work colleagues, definitely. I do keep in touch with a very limited number of people who have also left the group that I've known growing up. That's the only real support base that understands me properly. But everyone does, when they know what your story is, they know your background, they generally will go out of their way to say, actually, you know what, I'm here for you if you need me.
Yeah. Well, I think you made a really brave decision, and I hope that I hope that things work out for you.
Yes, definitely. No, it's been a roller coaster journey, but we're definitely on the up.
Yeah.
Just restarting your life really from scratch in every area is what it's about.
Yeah. Thanks so much, Vaughan. Really appreciate your time this morning. That is Vaughan Thomas. For more on the Ree series on cults and religious sects, you can go onto their Facebook page, which is facebook.com/ReNewsNZ.